Talwani. I, Bhumika Vasiani, welcome you all to learn English with Saraswati Group of Education. Today, we are going to go through the explanation part of the poem. What is the name of the poem? Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore. That is a little bit lengthy title, right? But yes, enjoyable and interesting poem which we are going to go through. Okay, in the previous session we had gone through all the new words so that we don't feel any hitch, we don't feel any difficulty in understanding the new words which we are going to come across in the poem today. So stay tuned and enjoy the poem.
Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, no doubt you have heard the name before, was a boy who never would shut the door. The wind might whistle, the wind might roar, and teeth be aching and throats be sore, but still he never would shut the door. His father would beg, his mother implore. Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, we really do wish you would shut the door. Their hands they wrung, their hair they tore. But Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore was deaf as the boy out at the Nore. When he walked forth, the folks would roar, Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, why don't you think to shut the door? They rigged up a shutter with sail and oar and threatened to pack off Gustavus Gore on a voyage of penance to Singapore. But he begged for mercy and said, no more. Pray do not send me to Singapore on a shutter, and then I will shut the door. You will? Said his parents. Then keep on shore. But mind you do, for the plague is sore of a fellow that never will shut the door. Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore. The moral of the poem is that one must be responsible and listen to elders.
Let us talk about Chapter 2, Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore. Now this is a poem. Okay? It is a poem about a boy named Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, who has a bad habit of leaving the door open. Now, this poem has very less sense, and that is a form of poetry in which imaginary characters are placed in funny and strange situations. Usually, this type of poetry where it is having less sense, the poetry has words and phrases that are made up and are quite meaningless. However, this poem is not entirely meaningless and has a message on manners. Okay, so let us see which is the bad habit and what is this boy named Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore doing. Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, no doubt you have heard the name before, was a boy who never would shut a door. Now this means that there was a boy named Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore. Now it is a very lengthy name, right? And you can see that the same consonant, the first consonant of the word is repeated again. That is G, G, Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore. G is repeated. This is known as alliteration. Alliteration is a form of literary language, okay, where we can repeat the first consonant. This is known as, that is a figure of speech. This is known as alliteration. Okay, now here we are talking about a boy, and the poet is also asking us that you must have heard the name of the boy, that is Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore, who has the habit of not shutting the door. He will never shut the door. Okay? Did you all hear about him before? No? Then let us hear right now then. The wind might whistle, the wind might roar, and teeth be aching, and throats be sore. But still, he never would shut the door. The wind might whistle, the wind might roar. Now here the poet is talking about the wind, that if we keep the door open, then the wind might whistle. That means even if the wind is mild, okay, the wind is blowing mildly, and even if the wind is blowing very heavily, strong wind is blowing, it is roaring, the roaring sound you can hear, then also this boy will never shut the door. And teeth be aching and throats be sore. Now, in which season it happens that our teeth are aching and throats are sore? That is in winter season. So the poet wants to tell that however cold it is, however our teeth are aching, however our throats become sore, but this boy will never shut the door. He will always keep the door open. His father would beg, his mother implore. Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore, we really do wish you would shut the door. Now his father would beg, that his father would strongly request him. His mother implore. His mother also will beg him, strongly request him, that Gustavus, close the door. But this boy named Gustavus Gore will never shut the door. He is not at all ready to obey his parents also, that they are requesting, they are telling him to shut the door. But no, this boy will not shut the door. Their hands they wrung, their hair they tore. But Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore, was deaf as the boy at the door. Now here the poet is telling that their hands they wrung, means they rubbed their hands against each other. They were so angry, they were so furious, that they kept on rubbing their hands with each other. But and their hair also they tore. But Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore, will not shut the door. He was deaf to the request. He will act as if he is deaf. He can't hear the request of his parents. Okay, actually he was not deaf, but he was just acting like that. And you can see in the picture the very carefree attitude of the boy. He is not ready to listen to his parents. His parents keep on telling that you have to close the door, you have to close the door, you have to close the door. But no, he will not listen. Let us go to page number 14. When he walked forth, the fox would roar. Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore, why don't you think to shut the door? Now he had friends also. Okay, that boy had friends also. So as he walked in front of his friends, the friends would shout behind him that Godfrey Gordon, Gustavus Gore, why don't you think to shut the door? Why do you have the habit of keeping the door open and going here and there? You have to shut the door if you open the door. So his friends were also worried about that bad habit of keeping the door open. They rigged up a shutter with sail and oar, and threatened to pack off Gustavus Gore on a voyage of penance to Singapore. Now his friends and his parents got together, and what did they do? They build up a shutter, means they build up a large boat from oar, and they threatened to pack off Gustavus Gore. That means they threatened, they said that we will send you to Singapore for punishment, on a voyage of penance to Singapore. That means we will send you on a voyage of punishment. Okay, not for the touring purpose, but we will send you for getting punishment to Singapore. Now hearing this, what is the reaction of Gustavus Gore? Let us see. But he begged for mercy and said no more. Now Gustavus Gore has understood that my parents and my friends are fed up of my this bad habit of keeping the door open. Now they are going to send me to Singapore for getting punishment. But I don't want to go. So he is begging for mercy now. He is requesting for kindness. That, oh mama, oh daddy, oh my friends, please show me some kindness and don't send me to Singapore for getting punishment. Pray do not send me to Singapore. See, he is telling, please don't send me. Please don't send me to Singapore. On a shutter, and then I will shut the door. He is telling that don't send me to Singapore on this large boat for getting punishment. I will surely shut the door from now on. And what does his parents and his friends have to say? Let us see. You will? Said his parents. Then keep on shore. His parents are telling that you will? They are asking a question. Will you shut the door? Sure. And if it is like that, if you are promising, then you have to stay true to your words. Keep on the shore means you have to stay true to your words. You have to be truthful that you will shut the door. Okay? It is not like that. Once you have said and then you one time you will shut and then you will again be the same person who is not shutting the door. But mind you do, for the plague is sore. His parents are warning him that mind well. Now you are famous for your bad habit. Okay, your bad habit is spreading like a rumor, like a deadly disease, that this boy whose name is Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore is never shutting the door. So your bad habit has spread so widely. So if you do not keep your words, then you will be punished. Of a fellow that never will shut the door. Godfrey Gordon Gustavus Gore. As I said, his parents are warning him that if you do not shut the door now and if you do not change your bad habit of keeping the door open, then your character, your impression will spread very widely, very soon, that this boy is not shutting the door. He has a bad habit of keeping the door open. Okay. Now, here, this boy has the bad habit of keeping the door open. Do you have any such bad habit? Not only of keeping the door open, but there can be other bad habits also. Okay, do you have that? If you have any, then please work on it and change that bad habit. Okay, now here we have an activity. Okay, please listen to the activity carefully. Now you will have to write that how a door is useful in a house. Think of as many of its uses as you can. How is a door useful to us? You have to think of its uses. Okay, please mention any two uses of the doors. Please mention any two uses of the door in our house. Okay, and the second thing which you have to do is you have to imagine that a door that has magical powers. Now suppose, what will happen if the door which is there in your house has magical powers? Describe the door. You have to tell the door about the powers of the door in detail, that is description. So describe the door and write about it, that all that it can do. You can tell that what all things that door, magical door, can do. Draw the door in your rough notebook. Okay, you have to draw the door in your rough notebook. Got it? So this is the activity which is related to the chapter. Find the two uses of the door which is there in your house and just imagine that if the door is magical, then just imagine that what all powers are the doors having in your house. You have to describe the powers of the door, okay, and write them. Any two powers can be written, write them in your rough book and draw a magical door in your rough book. If you have any questions, you can ask me during the live lecture.
Now look at the manners of that boy. This poem also teaches us about manners of closing the door once we open that. And many of us don't follow that manner, right? That is one of the good manners which we should consciously follow. If we are opening the door, we should close that also. And here, this boy was threatened by the parents that we will punish you if you don't close the door now. Then only that boy started following all the good manners. Especially this one of closing the door. Right? So you don't do that. You have to follow as it is. As your parents say. Okay? Now along with this video lecture, you are going to get a worksheet which you have to do as homework. In the worksheet, you will find two questions. First question will be fill in the blanks and second question will be true or false, which are based upon the chapter, upon the poem which we have just gone through, which we have just learnt. Okay? So please watch the video lecture again, or you can read it from the textbook again. If you do not get answer of any blank or to get the answer of any true or false. Okay? Now there are two ways of doing the worksheet, as you know. Either you can take the printout of the worksheet and write the answers in the worksheet itself, or you can write the worksheet, copy the worksheet in your rough book. Okay? But if you are choosing the option of copying in the rough book, please make sure that you copy it neatly and you write without spelling errors. Okay? If there is any confusion in your mind regarding the explanation of the poem or any question regarding that, then you can ask me during the live lecture. Okay? See you in the next lecture.